It's lovely to have you here because we've got this. This is, I think it's Netflix's first Irish production, essentially, yes. with The Wonder. So it's based on Emma Donoghue's book. What's it about?
So it tells a story. It's set in 1862, by 10 years after the Great Famine of Ireland. And it tells the story of Lib Wright, who's a Nightingale nurse who's been sent over from England to Ireland to a small community in the Midlands to conduct an examination of this young girl called Anna O'Donnell, who has alleged hasn't eaten in over 4 months. And so she essentially has been sent over to sit and watch and see how this miracle is happening.
Okay. So, had you heard of this phenomenon, the fasting girls, before?
No, this was the first time. Like, obviously, Emma Donoghue, it's written, but it was based on the book by Emma Donoghue, and Emma had done extensive research on the fasting girls. But yeah, it was something that I wasn't aware of until reading the script and then obviously the film.
It's a, like, because I didn't know about it either until I saw it. I was like, what?
Which is saying something.
These girls went for months and months and months, and obviously it was treated in different ways. Modern days, it might be treated like anorexia nervosa and all that kind of stuff. But how they were treated. In this film, it's this bunch of men that kind of want to canonise this little girl, being like, oh, she'll have sainthood because she's not eating and all this kind of stuff. And there's sort of a dark twist, and your character does that thing where you're breaking the fourth wall.
Yeah.
Talking directly to camera. How is that?
Yeah, it was weird, because obviously the whole point is that you say, don't look at the camera. But, you know...
you spent years not looking at
the
camera.
Don't look at the camera, yeah. And so that's the idea of, you know, Sebastian Elio, who's the film's director, he uses this framing device where you've got this character, Kitty, who is in the story, but I also introduce the film as the idea that stories are there to transport us. It's the idea that if you allow yourself to get lost in a narrative, it's the idea of what stories mean, why we choose to believe in them. And, you know, stories help us understand the world. They help us, I suppose, deal with trauma in a certain way. And I suppose that's the idea of this story, is the idea that we're letting you in this story, and we hope that you will believe in it as much as our characters do.
Yeah. Interesting. And listen, it must be nice to be back home, because, you know, you're from Mullingar, based over in London, but just to be back filming on Irish soil again.
Yeah, well, actually, it was such a lovely kind of, it was a 180, basically. The Johnny Shaw, shout out to Johnny Shaw. He was our first AD on the shoot, and I worked with Johnny many years ago. He was the first person who gave me my first acting gig. He was a third AD on a show, and I was a production assistant, and I was working in the art department, in the trainee department, and he asked me, he was like, on the Friday, he's like, I know you're doing acting, do you want to come in on Monday and be in a scene? I was like, okay, yeah, go on. And so I was in the scene, and it was amazing, because that gave me the opportunity to pay for drama school. And so thank you, Johnny Shaw. You're the reason probably why.
Take all the little jobs. Take the ones. Work on a set. Work on it just to get to there. That's the first thing you're working as a production assistant.
Yeah,
thing you're
that was
on
it.
Camera.
I was like, I got advice, and it was like, if you want to learn how to do something, you know, kind of go behind the scenes and see if it is what it is that you want to do.
With all this, like, it's an amazing cast, and Emma Donoghue had a little, I think she said she got it, we were talking to her recently, and she was edited out of the movie, the author, even though she was in, she's like, I'm on the chopping room floor. But then everything since it's happened, it must be so weird to come back for the premiere and see Florence Pugh and be like, oh, so, like, you're the biggest Gossip Column person in the entire world. Everyone's been talking about you for 4 months. Let's go for a pint.
I think, more than that, she's an incredible actress.
She's amazing.
You know, her talent is just incredible. Not only that, she's so intelligent, and she's such a kind human being. And to work with someone, you know, it's... Your lead kind of sets the tone on set. And when you lead with such kindness and grace and professionalism that she does, it's really inspiring, and we were so lucky that we had Florence on this.
Were you able to kind of go, act out with that professional, let's go for a pint?
Yeah,
I know where to go.
Yeah, of course, absolutely. No, we did. We were in Elephant and Castle a few nights for some chicken wings.
chicken wings
in Elephant Castle.
This is what we want to know.
In Guinness. Yeah, no, because we were having a few last night. So yeah, it's that idea that you can't get any Guinness better than here.
You had a nice night last night because you were at the premiere. And fair play to you. You look absolutely smashing, but you had a nice night.
I had a nice night. We got a great team. It was my hair and makeup, so I did not wake up like this. This is definitely not how I woke up a couple of hours ago.
What's going on? Can I ask, what's in the water in Mullingar? Do you all hang around together? Yourself, Brezzy, Niall Horan, like all the lads, are you all meeting up all the time going, Leo, no, she's not from there. Are you all just going, how are you lads? How's it going? No. The Mullingar massive.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on. What is in the water in Mullingar? I don't know. Yeah, it's just been an incredible town. You know, we've got like, I grew up with an amazing art centre run by Sean Lynn. So I was very lucky that I was involved in like a community art centre from a young age. And my mum, who sat over there, she loved it because I'd go in on a Saturday at 9 a.m. and go home at like 7 p.m. and it was the best.
Oh, you didn't have to deal with her at the weekend, Angela.
Yeah. Right. We were very active kids, so she was delighted that we had, you know, the whole day where you're in one place. But yeah, for me, it was community theatre, and I think Noel was the same. I think he was a part of the Art Centre.
Yeah, he was. And like, it just shows actually the arts, how important that is, and it's something that kind of got neglected a lot during COVID or whatever else.
And the recession.
And also, like, the benefits we've seen, like yourself, you've also worked with Barry Keoghan on another Irish film as well. Like, I mean, Irish art is so, so important, so worldwide. Mm-hmm. What was it like working with him? Because he, of course, is now going to be in the new DC Marvel as the Joker.
Yeah, what an incredible role. And, you know, it's quite a high-pressure situation, I'd imagine, to be on, because, you know, the actors that have played that character before, but he's doing incredible, and you know the work that he's, you know, he sets his aims really high, and it's it's inspiring.
Yeah, he was amazing as the Joker. And you also have this fabulous claim to fame. I don't know how your family and Angela feels about this, but you're in the surroundings like Hozier, Katie Taylor, Dermot Kennedy, anyone who's famous from Ireland, because you were a breakthrough Brit. Yes. In 2019 at the BAFTA. How do you feel about being a Brit, Niamh?
That's great. I know. I got so much slack over that. My God. But I've lived in London now 6-7 years, and it was terrifying for me. I grew up in Ireland, and I hadn't kind of travelled abroad. I had travelled abroad, but I hadn't lived abroad, and I was, you know, welcomed with open arms over in London, and yeah, Britain likes to obviously claim it's Irish.
As soon as they do,
I know.
As soon as they do, you're like, I've made it. It's grand. Like, Joanne McNally was so happy when she was like, British.
Oh, yeah. Of course she was. Was it hard, that move? You know, to try and to up sticks, to go to London, just trying to pursue this career?
Yeah. I couldn't get an agent in Ireland, so I had to go to England.
Yeah.
Yeah. I know.
Look at me now.
It worked out well. But it was great. There was an amazing community of Irish actors that were over there, and I was, you know, sleeping on couches. And, you know, so, it's, you know, it's just when you're starting out in your career and there's other Irish actors to kind of, it's like that lovely support, that lovely family. And I was really fortunate that I had that when I moved over.
And working with the likes of Ridley Scott and Raised by Wolves, so many things that you've done, like Cam with Horses is such an amazing movie. What's next?
I've just wrapped on a medical drama called Malpractice. So that was 3 months. Yeah, so I was working with an incredible team of A&E consultants playing a junior doctor in A&E, directed by Florence Pugh.
You've got it all going on. Of course, well, listen, if people want to watch, The Wonder is available on Netflix. And Niamh Algar, you're a huge part. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Morning.
And thanks for bringing in Angela. Cheers. Thank you so
Angela.
Much.
That's all we have time for. Listen, have a great weekend.
Happy Halloween.